Hi, my name is J.S. Cournoyer, and welcome to Entrepreneurs at a Crossroads, the series that gives you an inside look into those crucial moments when a small business comes to a fork in the road and its leaders need to make an important decision. Here we are at Lee's Music in Kamloops, British Columbia. This music store has been around since the heyday of Led Zeppelin, but the company didn't kick it into overdrive until recently when they started to design and build their own innovative guitars. Let's go check it out. Hi, Mike.
Hi, JS.
How you doing?
Very good. Nice to meet you. My dad started the music store in the 70s. I was totally born into this industry. Okay. Yeah. I was taking apart guitars to get the pieces so we can repair customers' guitars. I learned a lot about innovations in the guitar industry.
Lee Miltimore opened his first music store in Vernon, BC. Mike left Vernon when he was 19 to start the Kamloops store. Lee eventually joined him, but in 2004 he left town to start a new store in Kelowna.
One of the voids that he left here was in our repair shop. We're getting busier and busier, and we needed to have somebody to repair our guitars. So I hired a young man named Mike Trellenberg. He's a fantastic artist. He started to build guitars, and he brought one in one day. Yeah. And we were like, hey, that's really awesome. Mm-hmm. We could offer a high-end, handmade guitar to whatever the client wanted. This guitar was about 100 hours to build, and that's part of the problem with doing custom one-off guitars. You know, something like this is $2,800 to $3,400, depending on what we put on there.
How do you make any money?
It's really difficult.
Yeah.
With razor-thin profit margins and prices basically fixed, Mike needed to find a way to reduce the cost of production.
One of the first things that we did to try to speed up the process of building guitars is I created the spinning wheel of death. Basically what I did is I took a furnace motor, I attached it to a pulley system, attached it to a stand, put it onto the table, and I let it rip. And it would sand it really fast. Mike, could you describe it in one word?
Terrifying.
Terrifying.
After fiddling around with different production methods, Mike discovered what he considered a basic flaw in conventional guitar design.
The problem with conventional guitar design is if your sides are just a little bit out of whack, you now have to join something like this to the body, and it has to lay like this. And this joint, if it's out like this or out like this, a millimeter, it makes all the difference between a great sounding guitar or something that doesn't play or is bad sounding.
Okay.
So you have to make that joint absolutely perfect.
After building 30 different prototypes and redesigning his shop to cut down on production time, Mike had a breakthrough.
All right, so our necks are basically just like this. So what we've done, instead of having a metal strut coming off the center and not terminating right through the end of the guitar, it now goes all the way through to the back end, and it's structurally reinforced all the way through, maintains its center point, but allows it to move up and down.
That's the innovation, that's the technology.
And then what it does is by adjusting this set screw in the back, it actually changes the angle of the neck.
Okay.
And that really allows us to do things like intonation adjustments for tuning and get the action just perfect.
How much time does it take you now to build a guitar?
Well, it takes us about 16 hours to build a guitar from start to finish.
This innovative design led Mike to enter the Young Entrepreneur Award Contest, where his online profile attracted interest from buyers in the US and Europe. It was then that Mike found himself at a crossroad. He realized that with the right strategy, he could sell his guitars to people around the world. But how was he going to reach them?
We're learning lots about woodworking, we're learning lots about setting up a manufacturing space, learning lots about marketing.
The first part of that marketing plan was to brand the new company.
So I see you wearing a t-shirt that says River Song Guitars, so is that's the brand?
We actually had a contest to come up with the name River Song, and we had 400 entries, and the guy that won it was a tattoo artist. He said, if you get a River Song guitar, I'll pay to have River Song tattooed on your body. And I'll do it myself, but I'm too much of a chicken to get a tattoo.
Okay,
so.
I was going to ask you to show us.
Now that he had a name he was happy with, Mike saw the potential of using the web as a promotional channel. He worked with communication and internet strategy experts to build a new website with a robust search engine optimization campaign and an e-commerce portal. But this is just the beginning.
But now you need investment. You know, build more manufacturing firepower. I mean, that's what's next for you, right?
That's basically what we're looking at. We're going to expand our manufacturing facility, move equipment out of the building, and hire more people, and we're running.
The online strategy has given River Song a worldwide presence, and now Mike is bringing his dad back to Kamloops to run the music store while he concentrates full time on his booming guitar building business.
For entrepreneurs at a crossroads, I'm J.S. Cournoyer. See you next time.